that we have to grow up our heart and to increase our heart by good morals and good manners and good behaviors. And the Quran al-Kareem, in this sense, the Quran, the ayat al-Qur'aniya, it invites people to purify their heart and their soul. يقول عز وجل في محكم تنزيل قد أفلح من تزكى وذكر اسم ربه فصلى. Indeed, whosoever purifies himself by avoiding الشرك and accepting التوحيد الإسلام shall achieve success. But those will prosper who purifies themselves and glorify the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and lift their hearts in prayer. وذكر اسم ربه فصلى. He is successful who grows and remember the name of his Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala. قال عز وجل ونفس وما سواها فألهمها فجورها وتقواها قد أفلح من زكاها وقد خاب من دساها. Allah Azza wa Jalla in this surah is swear by the soul, by the heart and the soul on him who perfected it and inspired it with conscience of what is wrong for it and what is right for it. He is indeed successful who caused it to grow. قد أفلح من زكاها. بيض الصور ونفس بيض الصور and the proportion and order given to it and its enlightenment as to its wrong and its right, truly he succeeds that purifies it and he feels that corrupted. يقول الإمام ابن كثير رحمه الله في تفسير مثال يحتمل أن يكون المعنى قد أفلح من زكى نفسه. من زكى نفسه بطاعة الله. قد أفلح من زكى نفسه بطاعة الله. وهذا قول الإمام قدد في التفسير. He is successful who cleared himself and purified his heart and the soul. He is successful who cleared himself and purified his heart and his soul. Other explain of this ayah or other opinion of the scholar, كما قال إمام ابن كثير رحمه الله, قد أفلح من زكى الله نفسه. الأولى قد أفلح من زكى هو نفسه. المعنى الثاني قد أفلح من زكى الله نفسه وقد خاب من دس الله نفسه. He is successful who Allah Azza wa Jal cleared himself and purified his heart and the soul. The first opinion, who cleared himself, and the second opinion, or the second meaning, who Allah Azza wa Jal cleared himself. And the two meanings are the same. Because Allah Azza wa Jal purified our heart, and also we have to purify our heart and our soul. This is about the definition of a tazkiyah. أما النفس, the definition of النفس, الروح, القرآن الكريم, the definition of النفس were mentioned in the Quran with the three description. النفس الأمارة والنفس اللوامة والنفس المطمئنة. الأمارة واللوامة والمطمئنة. The commanding self or the commanding نفس, the regretful نفس, نفس اللوامة, and the contented نفس. What is النفس المطمئنة؟ النفس المطمئنة التي اطمأنت إلى الله عز وجل وإلى أوامر الله عز وجل واستسلمت لنواهيه. This نفس that are satisfied and approached to Allah سبحانه وتعالى and surrendered to the orders of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the prohibition of Allah Azza wa Jal. This is the nafs al-mutma'inna who accept the religion of Islam, who accept the manhaj of Nabi Muhammad alayhi salatu wa salam. النفس اللوامة من اللوم التي تندم كما قال ابن عباس، تندم صاحبها على ما فات وتلوم عليه كما قال ابن عباس وكلمته قتادة. The regretful نفس، the regretful نفس، النفس اللوامة that will make you regret the sins that you did. So you have also to remember your sins, your ma'asi, and also it push you to remember and to regret the sins you did before. And this opinion of Imam Ibn Abbas rahimahullah to Ruman al-Quran and his student Qatada rahimahullah. أما الأمارة، النفس الأمارة، the commanding self. This nafs encourage people to follow their desire, to follow and to make sense and to make ma'asi. And it invites people to stay away from the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So those are the definition or the description of nafs in the Quran al-Kareem. Inshallah, we talk now about أهمية، the importance of تزكية النفس، the importance of purification of the soul. Allah سبحانه وتعالى، He swear in سورة الشمس، سبحانه وتعالى 11 times in سورة الشمس، that He is successful who purify His soul, and He is successful who purify His heart, and He is a loser who neglect the purification of his heart. لأن النفس تعتبر أكبر عدو أو من أخطر أعداء الإنسان. The nafs, one of the most dangerous enemy of the insan, the person. Why? لأن النفس هي التي تدعوك إلى الذنوب، تدعوك إلى المعاصي وإلى الطغيان. This nafs leads the person to make sense and to prefer dunya more than al-akhirah, the hereafter. Why تزكية النفس is very important? لأن أمراض القلوب كلها تنتج من إهمال تربية وتزكية النفس. All the disease of the heart came from neglecting the purification of the soul and the purification of the heart. الحبيب المصطفى محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم كان دائما في كل خطبه يستعيذ بالله عز وجل من شرور النفس، ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا. That why محمد عليه الصلاة والسلام peace be upon him صلى الله عليه وسلم seek refuge of Allah سبحانه وتعالى from the evil of النفس in every خطبه. Every khutbah عليه الصلاة والسلام is seek refuge of Allah سبحانه وتعالى from شرور النفس, the evils of النفس. قال أحد العارفين بالله، أحد السالكين، انتهى سفر الطالبين إلى الظفر بأنفسهم، انتهى سفر الطالبين إلى الظفر بأنفسهم. One of the scholar and one of the pious scholar said, the troubling of the صالحين, the pious worshipper, has ended when they started to control their self and when they start to purify their heart. Why tazkiyat al-nafs is very important? Because tazkiyat al-nafs هي طريق الجنة, the way to الجنة, the garden. The proof, قال عز وجل, وَأَمَّا من خاف مقام ربه ونهى النفس عن الهوى فإن الجنة هي المأوى فإن الجنة هي المأوى. But as for him who feared standing before his Lord سبحانه وتعالى and restrained himself from impure evil desires and lust, verily الجنة will be his abode will be the garden. إذن فالتزكية شرط لدخول الجنة والوصول إلى الجنة. Therefore, the تزكية is a condition to go and to enter جنة الله سبحانه وتعالى. Also, الإنسان الله عز وجل فطره على حب الكماليات وعلى إكمال نفسه، ومن كمال النفس تزكيتها وتربيتها. The human love to be perfect. So he should care about his nafs by making tazkiya and tarbiya. كما أن النفس أو كما أن الجسد يمرض ويتأذى فكذلك النفس.